The second thing I said was that we always, it's easy, much easier to gain speed at a turn. This probably applies to companies as much as it applies to us as individuals. Cisco is actually a good example of this, and this is my only advertisement for the evening. Cisco has done a very good job whenever there is a turn, whether it's a turn for the down or a turn up again to grow, because it allows us, when there is a turn, to focus and prioritize and think about what is really important to us as leaders or as companies. By the way, other companies who are trying to do that in this downturn, Walmart is a great example of a company that's trying to figure out how they can expand the demographic that they serve because times are tough. I'm sure there's other, many other great companies like that. Ford Motor Company is another one that's trying to do that. When you see these companies, when you think about right now, we are in a very bad downturn. Probably none of us in this room have been through one that is as severe as this one or as unpredictable as the one we are in. We have to look at it as an opportunity for us to gain focus, learn new skills, and prepare ourselves for the growth that's going to come eventually out of this cycle. So that was my second thing. The third thing I said, and this is probably a little controversial, but I'd like for you to think about what I'm about to say. Opportunity is a mold that is waiting to be reshaped. I don't subscribe to the notion that there is ever a perfect fit for a job. Whether you're recruiting people or whether you are being recruited for a job, there is no such thing as a perfect fit. It doesn't exist. And I also don't believe that opportunity only comes once. People always say, don't miss this opportunity, it's not going to come again. And why do I say that? Because each of us are in a mold at any given time. And it's up to us to break out of that mold and recreate the opportunity or the person that we want to really become. In my own example, I was happy, comfortable doing my thing at Motorola. John Chambers called me and said, hey, I want you to come to Cisco. And I said, no, it's not going to work for me. My family is in Chicago. I had a huge network in Chicago. My son is in high school there. I can't do it. Well, we parted ways. 8 months later, he called me again and said, would you like to come to Cisco? I said, John, it's not going to work for me. And I said, I just want you to think about it. Maybe it'll work. And I thought about it, and I said, Cisco is a company that I really, really want to be part of because I see this as a company that can recreate what the internet's going to be in the future. And I wanted to be part of that transition. So I figured out a way to make it work. My family still lives in Chicago. My husband runs a company there, so he's not going to leave his job and move here. We have a son in high school, and we go back and forth. So the point is, if you're passionate about something, you will find the courage to break the mold, and opportunities will find you. And it's up to us to make the fit happen. The fit's not going to come to you. We have to work hard to make things fit so that the job feels right and it feels right for us as individuals. Okay, so how many did I do? I did three. So the fourth thing I said was leaders blur boundaries. And this one's interesting. And this I learned the hard way, by the way. Because if you think about our world today, increasingly, for us as leaders and for all of you in this room, it's very important to have the ability to work across functions in a company, work across company boundaries, and work across country boundaries. And when it comes to execution in real life, that is very hard to do. Think of even time zone differences. Cisco has telepresence, so we now use telepresence to do most of the meetings, which is a great technology, but we often forget that when we set up a telepresence meeting during the day, people in India should be sleeping, and it's not the right time. Certain things we can't change with technology, right? So working across boundaries and having the ability to figure that out is very important. Earlier in my career, I used to think, it's great to have a large group where you can control everything, you dictate a direction, you feel really powerful, everybody follows what you're doing. I used to have 26,000 engineers reporting to me. Wow, that was great. But I have learned that it is much more powerful to have the capacity to influence across directions, influence the industry, make people listen to what you're doing, rather than be in charge of a large, monolithic, static group that you can't do anything with. And that's a tough lesson to learn, but I think increasingly in the future, it's going to be very important for leaders to understand that and recognize that. Then I said, recognition, the best way to earn recognition is to give credit away. Give credit away, recognize other people openly, freely, frequently. And this is also easier said than done. How many times have you gone to a group that either you're part of or you're managing and found that people are not sharing critical information with their team members because they're afraid credit will be taken away from them? How many of you have had this experience? I keep telling people, you know, ideas get stronger when you share them. Make it somebody else's idea and see how fast they run with it. It'll get implemented before you know it. So gather a lot of suggestions, but give credit away. That's the best way recognition will come to you, because it'll come back, the credit will come back to you in spades, and you will be amazed at how quickly that'll happen.